You mentioned that masculinity is under fire at the moment. What do you kind of mean by that? Because I see two extremes almost. There's the kind of Jocko Willinks of this world that just flash up their watch on Twitter and show it's 4:32 a.m. and he's out of bed already and crushing the day. And then you've got people who are more in touch with their with their masculine side, but also with their emotions still, much more so. And I know, like, I'm raising two boys. They're 11 and 13 at the moment. And it's quite interesting seeing their emotions and how they sometimes have to be tough. But what do you mean by masculinity kind of being under fire?
Well, I think from a man's perspective, like, we're lost as to who we're meant to be. Like, there's, you know, there's the whole Me Too movement, and it's like, you want us to be kind, but then you want us to be manly, and you want us to be this, but you also want us to be that. And it's like, I don't know, what do you want from me? Who am I meant to be? Like, you want me to be forthcoming and strong and courageous and you know, show my courage by confidently speaking to speaking to women and showing that I'm interested, or men, you know, and being bold in my approach, but then I can't harass you, and how does this, and there's so much like, well, who am I meant to be? If I'm being kind, then I have to just give you space, but then I'm being weak because I'm not brave enough to speak to you. Like, there's all these contradictions as a man. Well, what are we meant to be? And so I think we get lost and we end up just going kind of, screw it, I'm just going to be whatever, like, I'm meant to be, like, and someone's going to moan at me either way, so I might as well just make to like do what feels natural. And the thing for me is that, from my experience, what feels natural, I've learned, is, as a man particularly, is that it's often ego-led behavior. Our ego is very loud and prominent, and it's something I'm looking into at a deeper level. But I'm sure, from a physiological perspective, you know, going back to the caveman era, looking at men and their role, is that we were the hunter-gatherers, and we had to be more on high alert. You know, we were the security ones that provided security to the family setting. And we had to be on more high alert. The amygdala was alive. Testosterone levels were much higher than the female. And I think we operate in that space. But in today's day and age, without being under threat, we take that energy elsewhere, and we think the threat is to people's perception of us, or that we might be perceived as a failure or rejected or embarrassed or all these things. I mean, I cannot be that, because that is not masculine. I have to be seen as strong and always together, and I've got this. So we take that energy, and it becomes unhealthy because we cannot ever admit that we're wrong. We don't know how we block out emotions, because emotions can be seen as weak, and without emotions we lack connection, and without connection we go chasing instant gratification, which often is unhealthy. And there's this whole knock on, all these things that just spring from fundamentally just being too attached to our ego, that lead to just so many negative ways of living. And I experience them, and I know that they look like they're ticking boxes, but inside of me and inside of the individual, there's a sense of like, something's missing. I don't feel fully alive here. And that for me is because we buried our heart. When you're alive, when your ego is really alive and you're really in tune with it, you bury your heart, and you disconnect from your emotions, you disconnect from your truth inside of you.